So, good afternoon, everyone. How's the Josh?
High.
Not too high. They haven't been snacks served yet. With all due respect, I welcome you all from the Vidyapeeth family. I thank ZSUD first of all for inviting us here and giving us the opportunity. To all the speakers who've shared their insights, especially Armstrong sir, because we hail from the same, let's not say ethnicity, but the same community which relates us somehow. And to all the elders, to all the seniors, to all the people who've put in a huge amount of labor, who've put in a huge amount of hard work. So, yeah, Vidyapeeth IAS Academy, I won't take much of your time explaining about who we are, but yeah, that's important that I introduce myself as well on behalf of Vidyapeeth. We are experts from Delhi. Yes, we have been mentoring students in Delhi and outside Delhi for the past kind of last decade. Vidyapeeth has a concept came after COVID, but the mentors involved in Vidyapeeth have been doing it for quite some time now. Yeah. We produce many results as well. I'll be talking about that as well. And we are, I would say we are decent enough content creators as well. We do create UPSC relevant content so that, you know, crisp and clear, just as sir said that he appeared for his exam 15 years ago. And UPSC has been very dynamic. It's sincerely called unpredictable service, public service commission, because of its dynamism. So we don't know what's coming next, what ball are they going to bowl at you, we don't know that. Who are we? Yeah, we are affordable. We are affordable in the sense that, I'll take some cue from Armstrong sir himself. He said that there are many, many students from the unreached, unserved part of India. It could be Northeast India, it could be South of India, it could be the West India, it could be the Jammu and Kashmir, it could be Zelangana as a region, it could be the Naga region as a whole. Yes, there are many people who cannot afford those hanky-fanky ivory towers, who cannot afford those high-end coaching institutions. So yes, we are not one of them. We are very affordable. Then we are very accessible as well. We are very accessible and we are very available. It means that UPSC today needs a lot of hand holding. Let us say you are a crowd of 500 and you have a doubt in your mind, at, you know, the last bench in my class has a doubt. How would that person reach me? Let's say you want to show me your answer. In a class of 500, it would be impossible for you people to reach out to me. So we aren't doing that. We are creating very, very short stuff, very, very small batches for you people so that every student reaches every faculty and we are totally accessible to them all. We are not expensive, obviously. We are not unavailable. We are not inaccessible. We are not this huge crowd. So this, yeah. So I'm really sorry. There's some noise here. Is there some disturbance? Yeah. So let's say you're sitting at the last mile of this classroom. For it's, you know, in a crowd of 500 to 600 people. I don't think that each and every child can reach out to the professor that, sir, okay, I did not understand what you said. And I don't think that the professor sitting here or taking the lecture would be able to resolve each and every doubt. So yes, we want to just dismantle this myth that the teachers are not approachable, your mentors are not approachable. This is why we wish to bring out a hand-holding model. We wish to handhold each and every aspirant because every child is special. One of you may have a very strong liking for history. The other one may have a very poor liking for history because history is very monotonous. One of you may be very good in mathematics. One of you may be solving those questions within fractions of seconds. The other person may not be good in reading comprehension or his comprehending skills may not be up to the mark. So yeah, we are here to bust that myth. What do we do? We create IAS officers, as simple as that. Recently, these are some recent pictures which I have. Divya, Rudraksh, Shivani, Himani, yes, the State Civil Services and the Union Public Service Commission as well. Arshia, Ajit and so on. There are many such examples which I can quote. I, I have just quoted the recent few which are in contact, which are in touch. Why are we here? We are here for a career in civil services. I am here to guide you. The motivation part has already been done by so many dignitaries. They've already motivated you what to do in life and what not to do in life. I am just giving you a brief that how do you pursue a career in civil services? What can you do to pursue a career in civil services? Let's make it even central civil services or the state civil services. One and the same thing, not much difference. I will be discussing within a few minutes what, when, how, who, and all those nuances of civil services. I will not take much role in describing you the events, describing you the stages, but otherwise, yes, I will talk you through the whole journey, how you can pursue it. So what is civil service? It emphasizes on two words. The first word is civil. Civil means the janta, the aam aadmi, the public, which is sitting here. It could be an orphan deprived of his right to education. It could be a child begging on the traffic signal. It could be an old lady who has been discarded by the society, by the family, by her sons, by her daughters. You know, it could be a pregnant lady. This is the most beautiful image of this world, I would say. Yes, a mother carrying a child. Yes, there have been instances of some uninstitutional deliveries in India as well because of, let's say, the lack of resources, the lack of opportunities. People have had some hardships. Yes, then there are the LGBTQ community, the transgenders. We always talk about the male and the female. We don't talk about the Nalsa judgment of the Supreme Court. I have never been taught by a transgender teacher. I have never had a transgender student in my class. So yes, there is still a taboo. Yes, we want to mainstream these people as well. So these are all also the part of we the people. We the people, the first three words of the Constitution of India. Right? Then yes, there is a tribal lady. There are a group of forest dwellers who are, yes, carrying the head loads. And then there is the Mother Earth. As an individual, an IAS officer does all these things. So civil services, yes, civil unka seva karna, serving the civilians of India. This is all civil services, I feel, is all about when it looks from the outside. Yeah. What is UPSC? Union Public Service Commission. It is simply an organization which conducts the civil services exam every year. It has a fixed timeline, it has a fixed schedule. We'll be telling you that as well in detail. Yeah, conducted by UPSC everywhere, every year. And then what do you achieve out of this? You get some posts on the basis of your rank and on the basis of your preference, on the basis of your choices. Those are called cadres, right, for all India services. So yes, you do get them. You become an IAS officer, an IPS officer, an IRS officer. So many streams, so many cadres, commonly known as the IAS exam, because an IAS is the most desirable man on earth, I would say. The most desirable post on earth, I would say. Yes? Why civil services? Now this makes it a little bit more interesting. Why should you have a career in civil services? Armstrong sir himself said that we need to think beyond normal jobs. Sir, I agree absolutely. I agree 1000% that we do need to think beyond normal jobs. But let's say we have a gamer here. What if I give you a perfect amalgam that I am none of these but I am all of these? I am not a principal, but I can still ensure that the schools of India run very well. I am not a nuclear scientist, but I can still ensure that the nuclear power plant in India runs as per the norms and conditions. I am not a doctor. I am not a doctor. I can still, by becoming an IAS officer, ensure that the hospitals of India are running up to the mark. I am not a civil engineer. Recently, 15 bridges have collapsed in Bihar. I am not a civil engineer, but being an IAS officer, I can ensure that those bridges do not collapse within the first year. Yes, they all have that expiry date of 20 years, 30 years. For a bridge to collapse after 30 years is a fine thing, but for a bridge to collapse after 6 months of its inception is not a good thing. So I as an IAS officer, or you as an IAS officer, my dear friends, can ensure that you are none of these, but you are
all of these. So this is what I've come here for. I've come here to give you a career prospect in which what can happen is you do not need a specialized degree. You do not need to be an expert in your field. You only need to be a journalist. But then you can move the country on your shoulders. You are a journalist, you are a common man. I'll tell you the eligibility and you'll laugh. That okay, this guy who has a normal graduation degree can become an IAS officer.
Yes, he does.
You don't have to have a rocket science under your belt. The fifth name can be, okay, the second achievement per unit age, per unit money, per unit time. Okay, I'm sorry, I messed up. I blubbed. Achievement per unit age, per unit time, per unit energy, per unit qualification. I think that is the maximum when it comes to civil services. Let's say a person of 21 years who is a small graduate and bachelor of arts from any common college, any tier 2, tier 3 college. Let's forget the high-end colleges like Miranda House or the Sriram College of Commerce or the Stephens or any other college. That's fine. I would say that a person who dedicatedly gives 1 to 2 years of his life with proper guidance, who is such a small age, who does not need to spend crores like an MBBS doctor or an MD doctor, who does not have to spend a lot of energy, he can become an IAS officer. But if we talk about the achievement, just sir, he himself said that we can act like gods. You can give, give jobs to the nurses. You can spend that resource on Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, you can give those houses, you can give those education, you can provide health to the poor, you can do all sorts of things. So yes, the third point is the 5 P's which I already broke. Yes, first is power. You get a lot of power when you become an IAS officer. With great power obviously comes great responsibility. Yes. Second is the prestige. Obviously, you satisfy your ego. You have a lot of, you have a big bungalow, you have a big car. Not a big car, you have people driving for you, you have people serving you. Yes, but again, with that power comes great responsibility that you are to give back to the community, just as an IAS officer sitting amongst us is doing. He gave us a lot of illustrations, Mr. Armstrong gave us a lot of illustrations that what you need to do, you need to give back to your community. Third is a purpose. You get a purpose in life. There is a Japanese word called ikigai. Can someone define what is ikigai? What is ikigai, my dear friends? Anyone? It's a chocolate question. Ikigai is a purpose in life. It is your purpose in life. What you know well, what you can do well, what you have interest in, and what pays you and what the society requires. Let us say I found my ikigai in teaching. I found my ikigai in mentorship. I felt that I know how to teach. I was decent at it. It paid me. It gave me a good salary. And then the world needs it. There are a lot of students who are not yet aware of how you could get into an elite job, elite government job, which gives you a career security. We don't know that. So yes, and then you are part of policy making. So there are two people in this world, one who get into the line and stand in their line and get made their Aadhaar cards. There are one such populace in this world. Then the second type of people in this world are, who will call Mr. Modi, that Mr. Modi, what do we want to do? We want to link, yes, the Aadhaar cards of these citizens and we want to mandate these Aadhaar cards with their phone numbers, with their PAN cards, with their mark sheets. Today you cannot fill any government exam or any form. You cannot get a SIM card. You cannot get a SIM card without an Aadhaar card. So who suggested to Mr. Modi that there should be an Aadhaar card in the pocket of all the citizens of India? It's the IAS officer. So one category of people I would say who stand in the queue and then they get their Aadhaar card, and the other category of people would suggest to the government of India that yes, you need such a such. Okay, there's a problem in this. Yeah. So the other category of people who suggested to the government of India that yes, we do need to work on these things. We do need last mile connectivity by linking your Aadhaar cards. Can we guess the fifth P involved? The first P was power, prestige, purpose, policy making. Fifth P,
yes.
Anyone? Again, a chocolate question. Are you people are not fond of chocolates? What about my girl sitting there? Yes, the dark chocolates. I'll give you the Belgian ones. Yes. Right, someone said so. The fifth P is Mr. Mame and Foo. Can we help you? See what this man has done. I'm not concerned about the awards which he's given. He may be India's most eminent IAS officer in 2015. He may be the most distinguished IAS officer in 2022. He may have been invited by Mr. Amitabh Bachchan for his talk show as the hero of the 9th episode. I have done my good research on you, sir. He may be the Young Global Leader Award, the class of 2018 by the World Economic Forum. But what he does is, that makes him great. He gives you a job, you are a person who cannot afford those high-five coachings, you know, you cannot afford those ivory towers, you cannot spend lakhs on your coaching, on your training. He gives you that opportunity free of cost. What better than that? You want to pursue nursing somewhere, you want to get placed in a good company, you want to pursue your dream career in, you know, so-and-so services in nursing industry in Canada or Dubai or in some Middle East country. This man is letting you do that, and that too with his own quota. That too with his own name. This man is a miracle man because he lets you build a road which you had never accessed. This man enables you to come out of your home when there is a sludge in your village, when there is a landslide. This is what I feel is the fifth P, the most important P. This is what an IAS officer can do. If you could define God on earth, I think if every IAS officer in this country or every civil servant in this country utilizes everything he has for the purpose of what he was there in the service, that is the civil service, then yes, he is none but the God on earth. Do you people agree? Oh, come on. Sir Armstrong is sitting, we have to agree. Yes. Yeah, we do agree. Because he hasn't spoken for himself. It is the people behind his back speaking for him. Moving further, who can become an IAS officer? I told you, you do not need to be a specialist, you only need to be a journalist. You have to be an Indian, obviously, then you have to be 21 years of age. Does that mean that you have to start preparing at 21? No. You could just pass out from your 12th, you could side by side self-study in your first year, in your second year, and your third year. And by the time you grow 21, by the time you grow 22, if you have in your mind that you want to pursue a career in civil services, you will be already an IAS officer when you come out of that, when you graduate out of your college. You have to have a graduation degree with passing marks. You don't have to be MBBS, or in other words, I would say you could be from any stream. You just have to be a graduate with passing marks. You don't have to be a topper of 99%. You don't have to be an eminent and distinguished scholar. You don't have to have so many accolades or prizes. You don't have to have a good general knowledge. You don't need to know what is the capital of Argentina or what was the name of Hitler's mother. You don't need to do that. You can be from any stream. You could be from medical line. I have taught MBBS doctors as well. I have taught chartered accountants as well. I have taught so many different, I have taught lawyers. I have taught so many other people. I've even taught people from the IT sector who become an engineer. Who's engineer? Any engineers in the house? Okay, there are no engineers in the house. You're all from the arts background. People from the arts background? Humanities? Okay, thank you. So yes, you could be from any stream. Stream obviously remains irrelevant, guys. Stream has no relevance here. Yes, there used to be a time when your stream mattered. There used to be a time when Sir Armstrong cleared his exam 15 years ago. Sir, there used to be two optional exams. And that is when you could have been a specialized in political science or in physics, or you could be a specialist in public administration. That would surely help you in your civil services. But today the civil services has become very generic. it has become very general. There is an ethics paper introduced in civil services, GS4, as a part of your mains answer writing. I'll tell you, I'll go through that. In that ethics paper, you all have to write general things. That what is the act of kindness which you committed in the past week? You would have just helped an old man fill up his application form in the State Bank of India. You could just have helped your household domestic maid with an advanced salary, or you could just have paid her children's for her children's education. You could have committed just that act of compassion. And this is what common sense is needed in the civil services today. So people of any stream can pursue this dream of civil services. When should you start preparing? Guys, I think you should start preparing right now. Whatever stage of your career you are, it's never too late and it's never too early. People have started preparing for the civil services right after their 12th ke baad hi they've started, you know, self-analyzing them, they've started reading a good quality newspaper. Just as John sir said, they've started going through the current affairs, they've started going through the current developments which are there in the country and the world. What is happening between India and America, India and Russia? Why is Russia targeting Ukraine? Yeah, what is the crisis there in our Manipur? What is the internal security crisis with respect to Naxalism in the red districts of India? Yeah, why is rupee declining so much? And all those things. You need to have that just generic knowledge, just general awareness about the current events of India and the world. And here you are. So you could start attaining that knowledge right from where you are. If you are in school, you could go for a junior newspaper or a junior edition of Times of India or Hindu. And if you are in your college first year, second year or third year, you could start reading with the Indian Express or the Hindu. Yes, you could do it. What is the pattern of the exam? Very simple. The first stage of this exam is Kaun Banega Karodpati. That is the talk show, Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. There would be a question. It would have four options, A, B, C and D, and there is no lifeline here. Koi lifeline nahi hai. You will be awarded negative marks for your wrong answer. MCQs, what all do you have to study? I'm sure you must have all studied history, polity. It is only prescribed for some of the posts of Staff Selection Commission, for some of the posts, not every post. This is all about UPSC and SSC, guys. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed delivering it to you. Thank you so much.